chemistry. It's one of those things that it almost seems mystical, right? Kind of magical. And if you don't know what you're looking for, you might not know if you have chemistry in your relationship. Everybody talks about chemistry, and it actually is really important. If you don't have it, well, chances are your passion is going to flicker and die out. So that's what we're talking about today. We're going to talk about chemistry in a relationship. Do you have it? Let's find out. And of course, before the great tips start flowing, why don't you do the big three? Make sure you like and subscribe. Hey, if you like the videos, why not? And of course, number two, turn on notifications so you know when next week's video comes out. Number three, leave me your questions and comments below. And of course, stick around till right at the very end where I sneak in one last tip after the credits roll. Stick around to the very end. First, let's talk about what chemistry is, because the more it's a mystery to you, the more likely it is you're going to make a mistake. The simplest definition of chemistry is that it's physical attraction to another person. It's definite sexual connection that just happens early on in your relationship. Now, there are two different kinds of chemistry. There's real chemistry and there's temporary chemistry. Real chemistry is the kind of chemistry where you have a genuine click between you. It's when you feel a certain special something that you can't put into words. And even though this means you have a connection, it doesn't mean you're soulmates or you're meant to be together. In fact, a lot of the time, this chemistry can cover up a lot of severe incompatibilities between the two of you. Real chemistry lasts. It won't fade away, at least not for quite some time. And it's a very necessary part of your long-term relationship. Now, the other kind of chemistry is temporary. This is where you may have been under the influence, or one or both of you was emotionally compromised. You know, the end result being that you wind up in bed or intimate with each other, probably too soon. And then later on down the road, you discover it was just a momentary thing between you. It wasn't real. Now, this kind of chemistry is only a problem if you try to build a relationship on top of it. This foundation won't hold up unless you find a stronger stuff for that base. Now, the dangers are having too much chemistry. Is that possible? Yes, absolutely it is. Let's be real. Sometimes chemistry pushes you into a decision you didn't mean to make. Come on, confess. You know what I'm talking about here. If you've ever had a one-night stand, you know what I mean. This can be just as lethal as the temporary kind of chemistry where you're under the influence. You can be under the influence of a passionate connection. But again, it doesn't mean the relationship is going to stand the test of time. Sometimes the chemistry can cover up a lot of broken parts. And another piece of the puzzle is that you need to have emotional chemistry. This is what they don't talk about. This is the kind of chemistry that makes you attracted to him, not just for the physical part and the sexual part, but the real spiritual connection between you. Now, do you have chemistry in your relationship? That's what we're trying to figure out today. There are definite signs you can look for that tell you if you have chemistry, and I'm going to outline them for you here, and you can see for yourself if your relationship has any of these signs. Now, just keep in mind that just because you have a sign of chemistry, this doesn't mean that everything's all good, go forward, green light, get married. You know, that doesn't mean your relationship is guaranteed to succeed or that you should force it to succeed. Not every relationship should survive. I know that can be hard to hear, but it's true. It can be difficult to deal with if you don't know how to handle the emotional hurt of a breakup. But clinging to a relationship that isn't meant to be, that's far worse. That's worse. And you might be aware chemistry is not the same thing as compatibility. So let's talk about some of these things about love and chemistry that will help you understand this a little better. Love and chemistry tip number one is love is not chemistry, and chemistry is not love. Getting these two confused is a source of problems for many people. Love is a connection that forges between two people over time, and chemistry is something you feel pretty quickly. The problem arises, as I've said, when we mistake chemistry as love. And I'm going to talk more about that one in a bit. Number two, tip number two, is chemistry is sometimes just lust. I have to put this out there. Sometimes physical chemistry is just a great excuse to get wonky with somebody, right? To get physical with someone. It can be hard to resist. But if you have physical chemistry, you also need to cultivate a certain amount of self-control and self-discipline. Because if you start with physical chemistry, you can very easily turn that into a relationship if you find that you're compatible down the road, right? I've had plenty of experiences with physical chemistry turning into very temporary relationships, mostly because I didn't show more restraint at jumping into bed with them. So that's why you have to be careful about moving too quickly. Tip number three, chemistry is sometimes codependence. Codependency is a bad word in psychological circles. It's not used much anymore because people tend toward other terms for it, but it's actually still valid. Codependency is when a person relies on the emotional connection to their partner or the relationship in an unhealthy way, and they both do this. They feel as if they can't survive without their partner, and they draw most of their self-esteem and their self-worth from that person or even the relationship. Sometimes these relationships can go really bad. Just watch some of the specials on Netflix. Hoo-wee, man. The important thing to understand is whether or not you're in an unhealthy relationship with a man. If you feel like you can't break free from that relationship, or you have psychological connections that you can't break on your own, you probably should seek some outside professional help. Tip number four, chemistry is sometimes just your shared purpose. There are plenty of examples where people have met and they connect because of the same situation that they're in, the shared circumstance. Maybe they were both in rehab or they were in recovery. Sometimes you work closely together and you mistake this for chemistry. The passion you share on a project might actually imitate a romantic connection. Some people meet at a Tony Robbins seminar or some other kind of self-help conference, and then they feel a connection, but it's a thin connection because of this. And that's why it's important to look at the circumstances around how you met him and make sure that they weren't out of the ordinary or a little bit odd. Tip number five, beware of destiny as chemistry. It's a common misunderstanding that when we feel a strong connection to someone, that it must mean that there's a spiritual connection there. You might think that you have a connection in a past life, or there's some kind of new age explanation for this feeling that you have. While that is certainly possible, the more likely explanation is something more realistic. What you have to watch out for is how quickly you're going to jump towards a mystical explanation as opposed to a real life explanation. Don't attribute any feelings you might have for a guy immediately as being a sign that you're meant to be together, whether that feeling is that you're soulmates or twin flames or whatever. Tip number six, chemistry is sometimes a combination of ingredients. Just like any good recipe, the love potion that you think of as chemistry has a lot of different ingredients in it. Let me give you just a few of them. Similarity. It's a widely known fact that people feel a connection to people that seem similar to them. Sometimes this can be misunderstood as being a kind of spiritual connection. Just remember that just because he seems similar to you in many ways, that doesn't mean he will be a good fit in a relationship. Familiarity is another one of the ingredients, and very often this feeling that a guy seems so familiar to you that can be misunderstood as being a kind of spiritual connection because of the weird deja vu sensation that you feel around him. Don't be blinded by notions of mystical romance here, okay? Contrariness is sometimes used as an excuse. Sometimes you mistake a man who is so different from your last boyfriend as being special because he's so different, right? In reality, you might have had a really bad relationship with someone and you find yourself seeking the opposite in a guy. That doesn't mean it's always right. If you've ever heard yourself saying, "Oh, he's so great, he's nothing like my last boyfriend," okay, and it feels so good, well, you might be making that mistake in this relationship. Mysteriousness is another ingredient that can really jack up the feeling of chemistry. We are all attracted to mystery, the unknown. Maybe it's because you had so many other guys who unloaded their life story on you in the first 2 hours of your first date, right? You get those guys. But when you meet a guy who seems quietly confident because he doesn't talk to you about his past, he doesn't tell you everything about him, you might find yourself intrigued by him. You might find his mysteriousness feels like chemistry. And there's a few more ingredients. I put them in the article at the site. If you want to read that, go on over to datingfire.com. Check out the article on chemistry and relationships. Chemistry tip number seven is stay grounded. The more you seem confident and relaxed, the more basically he seems confident, then the more likely you're going to find each other attractive. Okay? The calmer you two are, the more you're going to feel like you fit together well. And yes, you will also feel an undeniable chemistry with each other. This is because confidence and security in ourselves transmits energy. One of the best things you can do is to keep yourself relaxed and calm with any guy you meet. The connection will feel even more real and the chemistry will follow. Now here's one that is really pretty cool if you take a moment to really think about it. Tip number eight, curiosity is contagious. The number one enemy of chemistry is fear, okay? And the opposite of fear is actually curiosity. Think about it. If you're curious and you're seeking understanding about something, you can't be afraid, you can't be in fear, and that's the best attitude you can bring to any relationship. A couple of the things you can do are maybe share your own stories that match his stories, give him that feeling of that connection. Ask questions of him that bring out details of him in his life. Stay curious about him. Ask a lot of questions. Stay curious about your relationship. The more you discover about each other, the more chemistry you create, naturally. Tip number 9, understand body language. One of the most powerful tools for creating chemistry is understanding and using body language to your benefit. Do you know the signals that men give off that say he's interested? Do you know how to mirror a guy to bring out attraction in a man? Do you know what men are looking for in your body language? It's vitally important to understand how to use your posture, okay? Your eyes, every part of you that creates chemistry with a guy. A lot of people have lost touch with their bodies in this day and age, and they've lost the understanding of how to use your body to create that chemistry naturally. Body language signals work on a subconscious frequency with men. That's why it's one of the most important methods. You probably already know this intuitively. All right, tip number 10, chemistry is compounding. The reality is that chemistry is created by multiple factors coming together. It's rarely ever just one thing. When you can stack body language with curiosity, with some of the other things I've just talked about in this video, you can create undeniable attraction with almost any man. Now, here are some of the signs you have chemistry in your relationship. These are definite signs. Chemistry sign number 1, there were sparks right off the bat. This is probably the most obvious one because it's glaring, it's obvious. When you meet a guy and you feel that click right off the bat, almost instantly, right? In fact, it's almost hard to keep your hands off of him. And this is where the problems usually start because you have such strong physical attraction, you're also more likely to dive into a relationship with this guy than leaving it as the hookup that it was meant to be or a short-term romance. Not every relationship is meant to survive, remember that. Some are okay if they're just short. In many cases, a lot of the women that come to me for coaching, they realize that the problems they're having in their relationship are not the relationship. The problem is they tried to make a relationship from something that never had it to begin with. Sign number 2, maybe there weren't the sparks weren't even there right off the bat. Sometimes the chemistry doesn't show up on that all-important first date. It can happen. But if you were fortunate enough to decide to go for a second date just to give it another try, or maybe you felt a little desperate, hey, you might have found out that you did have a little bit of physical attraction there. Sometimes the chemistry doesn't show up instantaneously, and that's okay too. That's why I always advise women to give a guy at least a second chance. Unless he did something horribly wrong, just give him that second chance, but not a third. Sign number 3, the compatibility shows up too. Sometimes you get lucky and you hit it out of the park right off the bat. You feel not only that zing when you're with them, but you also feel that you two have a lot in common. This is an excellent sign, and it's one that you should focus on. Again, it doesn't mean the relationship is going to win. It doesn't mean that it's destined for heaven or even marriage, but it gives you, both of you, the most important building block of a relationship: attraction and compatibility. Sign number 4, in the body. As I mentioned earlier, body language is essential for creating chemistry. If you see signs of attraction from his body language, pay attention. Men broadcast their interest in you in many different ways, and his body language will be the easiest one for you to spot. Sign number 5, you both like Seinfeld. Okay, maybe not the show Seinfeld or exactly Seinfeld, but you both share the same kind of comedy, the same kind of taste in comedy, or the same things you like that are funny. That's a big sign. When we share a sense of humor, we immediately share a very basic level of connection and chemistry. It's one of the best signs that a person is a good fit for you. So if you like the same comedy shows, the same comedians, cartoons, whatever, then this is a good sign that you might have that chemistry. Hey, I don't have enough time and space today in the video to be able to go through every single one of the tips, but if you want to get all the rest of them, and there's a few more, go on over to datingfire.com and look up the article on the site. Just go to datingfire.com and check it out. But here, before you go, this is important. Most women do not get the kind of success they deserve with men. I know it's a pretty bold statement, but it's important. To put it bluntly, most women don't do very well with men, especially today. Even when she gets a boyfriend, all you see is how deeply disconnected these two people are. I'm sure you've seen this in a lot of couples. I know I have. It's just not the kind of happy romance that you expect. It's not what the standard you want for yourself. You want a real relationship, a heartfelt connection with a man that you can trust in. To do this, you gotta have a powerful connection with him. You gotta have an unbreakable connection. And there's a simple trick to getting a guy to feel like you're the one for him, just based on your power of connection to him. With this kind of connection, you never have to worry about him getting bored of you or getting bored of the relationship. You never have to fear him falling for another woman. Now, if you want to learn about this, this is what I call the ability to connect with a guy. And most women don't have it. They don't understand men. They don't know what men want. They don't understand what men are looking for in a relationship. Now, if you want to know what that is, I can show you. I've got a great newsletter that'll tell you a lot of these tips in my daily newsletter, as well as I'll be giving you more video tips and even a free ebook on what it is that destroys that connection between you and him. Just go to the link you see below me here. That's datingfire.com/7mistakes. That's datingfire.com/7mistakes. Go to that link and you can get my ebook, my free ebook. Costs nothing. I'll send it to you. It's great. It shows you the mistakes that women make that make men pull away. You'll be able to understand the real reasons that men run from relationships. Why do guys pull away like they do? Why does he start off so hot and heavy, but then he cools off so quickly, and then you spend the rest of what's left of your relationship trying to win him back? You got to know if he's still interested in you. You've got to know if this guy is actually capable of committing. You got to find out if he's emotionally withdrawn, or is there something else that you can fix? Go get your copy now. Go on over to datingfire.com/7mistakes. And hey, before you run away, don't forget, a few more seconds, I got another tip right after the credits roll here, but of course, make sure you, what? Like and subscribe. These are awesome videos. If you stuck around this far, you must have found something good in it. Number two, make sure you turn on notifications after you subscribe, because then you're gonna know when the next video comes out. And if you got questions or comments, or you just wanna suggest a video, leave that in the comment section below. Hey, it's Carlos Cavallo from datingfire.com and datingadviceguru.com. As always, live and love with passion. Another sign for you that you've got this chemistry is that you find it easy to be honest with him. One of the most important signs of chemistry is that communication just seems to flow between you two. You'll probably find it easy to talk about things that are slightly embarrassing even with him. What this means is that you don't fear this connection or a loss of affection by being vulnerable with him, which is essential for your future communication with him. If you find yourself revealing stuff from your past with him and it's not due to how much alcohol you had that night, there's a good chance your chemistry is solid. And this sign also speaks to your compatibility.